So we've made it to check in. We're here, look. There's the big marquee. Sea of orange. Here's check-in, bit of a lineup.
We want to officially open this event. We've got this little ceremony that we do. It's just a symbolic little thing. But we do that with someone really, really special who's a great bloke. And I don't know how he did it. There were so many people. It was like the lottery. He was trying his hardest to get the 001, the first ticket that became available. We literally opened the website. We said we'd open it at a certain time. And I don't even know how he managed to type it in so quick. But literally a minute later, boom, in it comes. I said, oh, we've got a registration already. And then they continually flowed for quite a while after that. But the first one was Chris. He's like, where are you, Chris?
Right here.
All right, come up here, bro. He's up the front here. Right at this moment, we officially declare Ridgewater 2 open! And we've got some pretty awesome entertainment for you right now. We've got a great night lined up. We've got some great speakers. We're going to be talking about the route. And teaching you a little bit more about Gaia and doing some other fun stuff tonight that will help you. So, ladies and gentlemen, and I know there are, I think, five ladies on the ride. So, yeah, good on you, girls. But for now, it's time for some entertainment. So, just put your hands together and give us a nice big round of applause for African Beats. Excited about it. If you haven't got a heated jacket, you've got balls this big, because I think it's going to be quite chilly up here in the hills.
The one thing that everybody says about these events is the riding was great, but I met so many good blokes. And I've got so many new friends, and I reckon that's awesome. Put your hand up if you're from WA. There's 1, 2, 3. All right. Talk about an adventure. Compared to the adventure. Now these guys are fully trained paramedics.
They've gone to a lot of trouble to have good quality care for you if it's needed.
Stay on the route. The golden rule, because we've got sweet riders and we've got support on those routes. The route that we've got for you tomorrow will take you to Goulburn. And it's at the Tattersalls Club.
So let's talk about the route tomorrow. And we're not going to go into a lot of detail, but there's a few things to remember. Tomorrow morning is Monday morning in Sydney. We're going to go up through Katoomba, over Blackheath, down Victoria Pass, and then we're going to hang a left out towards Oberon.
There is plenty of fuel tomorrow. There's 317 k's to do. We're at the foot of the Blue Mountains at the moment, and there's about 60-odd k's to get up to the top. The creek crossings are deep. There are a couple of deep ones on the main route. This is the best crew that we've ever had, and I'm so proud to have every single one of them here. You've placed trust in me, and we're going to give it back to you. So thank you all very much, all right?
Ridge Riders, welcome to the TAS in Goulburn. Did you have a good day today? Excellent.
Everybody else has arrived safely, and today's been a fantastic day. Compared to last year, we had 6 people in hospital at this time. Then Daryl Heckelman, you are one of those riders.
Yep, so now click on map in the bottom corner. Now when you zoom down, you will only have today's route.
Yeah.
There you go.
Thanks, guys.
Right, I hold there.
No worries.
There you go.
Yeah,
there you go. Well done.
Perfect. Well, we just took a layer off, you know.
Yeah, it's good. How was the first breakout?
Awesome, yeah, through the water.
Oh, I can see you went there because you got the yellow dust on your face.
Oh, no, it was great. I think a lot of guys missed it.
I think so too, yeah.
We actually did for a start and realised and went back.
Yeah, been having a good morning?
Oh, having a great week.
Yeah, fantastic, yeah, yeah.
Really?
Nah, it's just... Better than being at work, make no mistake.
Oh, hell yeah. Nah, just the way it's been run, you blokes, unbelievable.
We'll be right back.
How was it today? How was the route?
Oh, that was the toughest I've ever done in my life, which is very easy. But the teamwork...
To get through?
The teamwork to get through with everybody, you know, chipping in.
Put your sunnies up.
Yeah.
So I can see your face.
The teamwork was fantastic.
Yeah, yeah.
So we got mates for life. Because everybody looks like this right now.
Yeah, yeah. Muddy, dirty.
Muddy, dirty. We all hit the dirt, or most of us hit the dirt.
Yeah.
They dug as deep as this.
Yeah.
We had to, you know, wedge him out.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
So tell me how the Harley Davidson went. Did it perform? Was it good?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It was fantastic. Yeah. I had one of my colleague riders do a little piece for me.
Yep.
He was like, this is the first time I've been on a Harley and I'm loving it.
Awesome.
That's what he said. So, you know, it performed really well.
Well, you're showing all the boys up. You're about number 20 in. Right?
Oh, am I?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's unreal. Did you do any breakouts or just stayed on the main route?
No, we did the first breakout.
Yep. Yeah. You got through the water?
No, I did not. I looked at the water.
And went,
and I was like, no. But I got across.
Yeah.
And the rest, I mean, we've done 7 hours over the first 200Ks.
Yeah.
So it was hard work.
Yeah.
It was good.
Awesome. All right. Well, I'm glad you had a good day. That's really good.
Can I have a beer now?
Yes, you can have a beer.
Oh, okay.
You can have several beers.
Okay. Thank you.
Fantastic, man. I'm telling you, that was mad. Absolutely mad.
So you did the breakouts? You did the normal route or what?
We missed number one.
Yeah. Oh, that was the best one, man.
Oh, you're joking at me.
It was so insane.
That second one was insane.
Yeah.
That was awesome. Real Karen, mate. And
the bike's nice and dirty, mate, so it looks like you had a good day.
Oh, yeah. I'm buggered. I dragged two of them bloody 200-kilo adventure bikes out of bog holes.
Yes. Well, it's beer o'clock now, man, so get in there get yourself a
damn pump.
A nail. She looks great when they're filthy dirty. It's all right, you didn't damage yourself?
No.
Did you?
Yeah, all the guys were helpful.
Yeah.
Dropping out the whole
way. Yeah, no, that's great, mate, good on you. Well, she looks the part, mate. I love it. See ya.
Yeah, great stuff.
You know what I mean? You have a good day, it's a good day for you.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
It's beer o'clock. Let's go. How'd you go today?
Excellent day. Had a great day, mate. Fantastic. Good riding.
Yeah, good, mate. Had a great day. Long day. Did a bit of everything. Really enjoyable. Had a ball. Lots of creek crossings.
You see some part of the ground off.
Oh, four stacks.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you okay?
Yeah, 100%. All good.
Okay.
The bike not so much, but I'm all right.
Okay. Did you have a good day?
Awesome.
Yeah?
Awesome.
Did you do all the breakouts?
Yeah, of course.
From 1 to 10, what do you reckon on this today?
So what I get you to do...
10.
10?
10. That second breakout was rad.
Was it?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
Even after the breakout. That was after the breakout. Those guys get bogged as mud holes and everything.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was unreal.
So you had a great day.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Today was great. Bog after bog after bog. Can't believe it. Oh, it was fun.
Yeah.
It was a challenge because of the amount of really bog holes we had to go through.
Yes.
And yeah, I mean, it was absolutely fantastic that the support crew were there because otherwise we would have been still sitting in these bog holes. At one stage there, I had my foot on the ground. It got sucked right into the mud. I couldn't get my foot out of the mud.
Yeah, right.
How'd you go today?
Oh, we had an awesome day.
Do all the breakouts?
What's that?
Do all the breakout routes?
No, we didn't do the breakouts, but we had enough bloody trouble on some of the main routes.
Yep.
We were picking up bikes for at least an hour, I reckon.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
How'd you go today?
Not too bad. Wasn't a bad day at all, actually. Bit of mud on the bike.
Fair bit of mud on the bike.
I sprayed that on myself. Deep bog holes, there was deep ruts. There was some challenges there, but we made it. That's the main thing.
Yeah, that's good. You all safe? Your bike's all good?
Yeah. Bike's all good. I'm hanging for a beer, though.
How'd you go today?
Yeah, good, man. Yeah, it was fantastic. Got myself caught in a bog hole, but other than that, it was good.
What'd you rate it out of 10?
9, sure.
Very good.
Yeah, no, it was an awesome day.
Peppermint 84. If you know what that word is, put your hand up. Alright. You guys all need to come out because you're all getting a beer from the guy that you dug out. And it took a 12,000 pound winch, five guys and some snatch straps to get the freaking thing out. So what they did is they all decided that they would go to the briefing tonight because James, who owned the bike and got it bogged up to its neck, said that he was going to buy everybody a beer tonight who helped, and the secret code word was Peppermint 84. So let me ask you again, who knows what Peppermint 84 is? I think some of you will have a new respect for the word breakout, won't you? Alright, tomorrow we are going down the iconic Barry Way. We'll talk more about Bright tomorrow night when we actually arrive there. There's a fair bit to go through when we talk about the day we're going to spend there and the loop rides that we're going to do. Forecast, I'm not bullshitting to you. 3 degrees tomorrow morning. Okay, it is going to be freezing cold on the motorcycle. So if you do want a jacket or a new pair of gloves, go and see the girls, they'll get you sorted.
Thank you. Let's talk through 10 minutes ago, keeping up with someone who was far faster than I am. Up this hill here, took this snotty little outside line, front tyre, skid, there's a rock, engine case on there, aluminium plate with wonders, hop, skip a jump, in the air, skid, 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 that's what ended up. Contact with engine case makes contact with ignition cable, ignition wire is now broken. Fixed.
Yeah, Richard Gordon, come up here, Tim. Come on up.
I want to meet my dueling partner on the 1290 KTM. O'Grady, I think his name is. Hand up.
Phil O'Grady.
I don't know this guy at all, but I was cruising along the Omeo Highway on my own, nobody anywhere near me, and this bloody KTM passed me. So I thought, geez, I can do better than that. So I gave it a squirt, and he gave it a squirt, and we had a duel all the way across the Omeo Highway.
We're going pretty hard. It must have been, I don't know, 70 or 80 kilometres. And I come up behind these couple of guys who had Richard behind them. And I stuck past the crew and got going pretty well. And then this thing, BMW, pulled out behind them. So I was, it's on. So we got going pretty quickly. And I tell you what, for a couple of big bikes on dirt tyres, we were probably 9 tenths most of the time. We were trail braking in the top of those corners, the 40, 50k corners, 35k corners. It just went on and on and on. And every time I looked in the rear view mirror, the bloody headlight was up my ass. This fella can ride.
I then went down to Metamitum for fuel, and then bugger me if I didn't get breath of ice. The cop was standing at the store right beside the fuel bowser, and we just got chatting, and he said, where have you come from? And I told him what we're doing. Anyway, we started chatting, and he finally said, would you mind if I breath of ice you? I said, no, I wouldn't mind that. He said, you're the first one today, I've got to get the quota up. He's up with my motto, it says, ride today for tomorrow.
And we call him Handsome Dave, all right? Because the bushy beard and all that shit, he's just got it going on, and she's loving it. Tell us what happened to you on the route on the first day, which led to you getting the flat.
I've got a flat, but I pushed a rock through the tyre, and then so I messaged Jay saying that I am here with a dead tyre, come and save me.
Sounds great, Dave. Yeah, sounds really good. Yeah, great photo, no dramas, and I'll see you at dinner.
This is on text, right? He sent a photo of his feet crossed in his really nice paddock in the sun. I'm thinking, because, you know, he goes off and does his own thing. He rides off and comes back, and then all of a sudden he's not behind us, then he is, and then he's in front of us. And we're like, where did he get there? And he just does his thing. So I thought, oh, yeah, he's sending me a photo of himself relaxing in the sun somewhere.
3 hours.
But he actually had a flat tire, and he's saying, hey, I need some help. And I didn't read the message properly because I was driving along. And then I was like, where's Dave? And I look at my message again, and I think, shit, he's got a flat tire. So I quickly ring Max and the truck, and they almost were about to go past him. They got him in the dark off the highway. So what happened today? You crashed? And?
I was following the young fella in the GS. Where is it? Where is he? He is fucking fast. He is very fast. So I was trying to keep up with him and threw it down the road. And
threw it down the road means he binned it big time, right?
So put the crash bar into the coil and then twist the wires together and where we go.
So talk about bush mechanics, right? He got it going. If you've ever seen The Man from Snowy River, the hut that they used in that movie is where you're going to tomorrow on this ride. It's a magnificent ride. There's plenty of twisties. You've just got to be careful. There are some hairpins, there's some switchbacks. If you're going too hot, you're going to find yourself in real trouble. So take it easy.
So my name is Jess, and I have to admit I ride a Harley Davidson. If you haven't noticed, it is actually my first time on the dirt. 20 years of riding, never been on the dirt. But I'm having a blast, and you know why? Because everybody's helping each other. And everybody's, you know, I've seen guys do 5, 6, 7 runs with bikes across, you know, especially the shit that we had yesterday, and still smiling and digging out bikes, and it was so good to see, wasn't it?
It was a great time.
Yeah.
It was, you know, 6 people pulling out of GS out of the mud. Yeah.
Or pulling you out of the mud.
Pulling me out of the mud.
And he said, you know what we should do? That dude's taking a pretty big hit. Let's send a hat around, a helmet around, and do a bit of a collection for Greg. I'm also going to kick the tin as well and give him back everything that we didn't spend. All right, so he's going to get some back from us, and I'm hoping this will cover the rest of it for him. Greg, I'm down here in Bright, mate, and I've got a whole bunch of people in front of me. Mate, I have got a very full helmet full of money here that we've raised for you tonight to help cover your costs of coming down here, mate, and missing out on this ride. Can you guys all give Greg a round of applause? Just let him know we're here. Everyone can hear you, mate.
Oh, great. Thank you very much, everyone. Oh, I don't know what to say. I'm just shocked. Still getting over this COVID, of course. I'm just wrecked. I'm absolutely wrecked. So yeah, thank you very much, everyone.
And that, to me, is what this is all about. It's about looking after each other. It's about having something to look forward to, having some fun at our age and doing shit we love.
tomorrow is my favourite day on the route. Okay, it is by far the best route. It's got a bit of everything in it, and I'm sure you're going to love it too. Hopefully, if it's sunny in the morning, you guys will have the best views ever seen around this area. So some of you probably already know where I'm talking about. Route opens at 7, and we want you to be gone, out of here, fueled up, and on the way by 8:30. 349 kilometres. We're estimating it's about 6 to 8 hours to do that. So there's a fairly decent ride. Make sure you depart with full fuel. You better pack a parachute tomorrow morning, because if you get one of these corners wrong when we go over this ridge, you'll need it. So just go nice and easy. In all the years I've been doing this now since 2016, and this is no BS, this group has by far been the most respectful, the most intelligent, you know, happiest group that I've ever had to work with. Thank you very much for all your efforts. Thank you for the way you have respected our crew. Thank you for listening and following the procedures, because we've spent a lot of time and effort to make this, you know, a good experience for you. And I hope you've all enjoyed it very much.
Just want to say, this is my second Ridge Rider, and MOTO Trekkin have been absolutely awesome. Just want to, three cheers for MOTO Trekkin. A bit! A bit! A bit!
great. Awesome day. Really great.
From 1 to 10, how do you rate the ride?
Oh, 10. Totally.
Fantastic.
Yeah, always.
Awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention? It's right on 7 o'clock. I love the noise coming out of this room. I could hear you almost out of the car park. All of you in this room are probably in a very small percentage of people in this country that have ever ridden between Sydney and Melbourne through the dirt and the Great Dividing Range. You are one of an elite few. Congratulations to all of you. How good was that route up over that over those hills? And just magic, hey? It is adventure riding. You know, we go pretty hard out there sometimes, and there are risks associated with it. He goes, no matter what happens, I want to kiss that hallowed ground at the Yarra. I'm going there, and I'm freaking going to lay on the ground and kiss the dirt. And he came through the check-in. He came in the car, but we picked him up on the way. But he came through with his helmet. He got a photo, and he was so proud that he just got to that finish line. So good on you, mate. Good to have you here. I'd like to give out a Champions Award because there is always somebody in the group that goes to a lot of effort to either continue or just to be here. There's some guys from WA and so on. This guy has got an unbelievable story of what he went through with a new bike that he bought. But he gets my Champions Award. Give him a welcome. I want you to meet Harley. Now, Harley is from Revit. He's a great guy. He supported us. We've got Revit on board now, so if you need any gear online in our store or to come into our shop, a gift for him. What do you got for him, Ali?
We are giving you, given the trouble we're going through, we want you to stay dry and safe, so we're giving you a Sand 4 jacket to your size and colour selection, whatever you want. So that's
$799.
Thank you very much, Ali. We really appreciate that, mate.
There was a BMW up to its neck in mud. There was all sorts of stuff.
For those of you who have found it pretty tough this week, good on you, because you've done really well and it's been challenging at different times for some of the terrain. I'm just wondering, is there any stories that you guys want to share with us?
When I came off and landed on my ribs, good people helped me, thank you. I decided to go to the hospital at Cooma. So I went off route to where all of you were going, and I'm cruising down, so there's one person in Hastings here, right? So as I'm cruising down, so by the wall, he pulls me out and he goes, mate, could you help me pick up my bike from about a kilometre down the road? I said, mate, I'm actually going to the hospital, I can't even pick up my own fucking bike.
When you fill in your forms to when you enter, the only thing it really asks you is, are you over 70? Who's over 70 here? How many people?
Richie.
Hey, Greg.
Oh, bullshit. Come on.
Four or five of you?
Mate,
most
of you look older than that.
I'll tell you why, because we need to know how much Viagra you're taking. I don't know. I can't even remember why I asked that question.
Actually a couple.
Okay.
Nico is crazy, right? He always goes, he wants to go the first. He always goes up first wherever we go. The fast riders were sitting at the bottom of this, you might recognize it. It just goes straight up. You're supposed to go around that corner, it's a normal corner, but it goes straight up like this. Chris, standing at the bottom, goes, okay, Nico, there. Okay, just without how stopping, saying hello, how's it going, blah, 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 and gets right to the top. Starts stopping, just looking at and you get, then he sees his map. It's white, right? It's white, or yellow, or whatever the color.
from green.
Black.
Bottom is like, hey, so hey, right, man, I wasn't supposed to go up there. I said, is that it? Is that the big tall thing that everyone's talking about? You know, the big track up? And no, that's not it. Me and Nico are talking together on our thing. It's a setup. He disappeared? You know, there you go! Stop! No! But guess what? James, who broke his ribs today, and the guy that's riding around like a loop. There you go. First one, he just goes, fuck, I'm gonna go and help him. I mean, and he went straight up, leg out. And then we actually go, fuck, poor Nico. Nico went up, right? Nico was coming down. Nico came down and we clicked on the center, right? I was like, oh, fuck, he's all right. Hey, guys, he's fine. He's coming down. He's gone. These fucking freaks are coming. Slap, you know, bang, bang. And he came back down and goes, there's another guy up there. Don't you?
This time. Who's made a new friend here? Wow. People say to me, I say, what did you love about it? And they say, oh, you know, the riding was great, but I've met so many new mates, and the camaraderie and the friendship and the mateship. And you know, when you're on the side of the road, if you've downed your bike, someone stops, helps you pick it up. You know, they'll help you dig your bike out, they'll pick it up for you, they'll help you along. That's what I love about these things. That's the primary thing. So if you've made a couple of good mates on this one, they could end up being like me. In my case, I've got some lifelong friends that I've created here and found on these particular events, and I'm really grateful for that. He worked all day, non-stop, just getting you guys through scrutineering. He's a participant. He didn't have to be there. He bought a ticket, but he kicked the tin. And then also today, running around, he came over, said, can I help you guys? Jumps in the bus, takes some bags over to Siebel or the Sage Hotel, and was running around helping us out this afternoon. What a champion, eh? Let's give him a round of applause. So what we've got, Andy, is we've got for you, mate, a hat, MOTO Trekkin hat and a t-shirt. We want you to wear that proudly. And we've also got a brand new set of tyres for you. That's what I say. I want to get them all up here because these are the guys that have made this happen for us. They're the people who have done the hard yards. So there's roughly 30 of us to support 220 of you guys. It's amazing, and I'm very grateful. I mean, you know, I'm nothing without them. This is nothing. This wouldn't have happened without them. So come on. All right, that's a final goodbye from me. Thank you, everybody. Really appreciate it. You guys have been terrific. And all the ladies, thank you for joining us. Dan and Jess from Harley-Davidson, and Ali from Revit for coming along and supporting us. Really appreciate it. Have a safe ride home, and I hope to see you on the next one. Thank you again. Good night.
Back on again. We've got Pedro. This is the sound of music. Running around like a Yeti. I can tell you a story about a Yeti. A Yeti that we just found. Don't fall over, Pedro. Look at the snow coming down. Oh, he's down. He's down. Oh, good times. Good times.